Good morning, chic, chic, chic. Before I do this video, girl, I'm in a very Mary J. Blige mood today, girl. Shout out to Mary J. Blige off the Mary album, bitch. All that I can say. I got her on repeat, bitch. Now, like, comment, share, most importantly, subscribe. Make sure you hit the bell notification so you can always be in the know of any future content that I got coming up. Now, chic, I should cuss your ass out. I just sat here and had to endure a whole hour of straight fakeness, fuckness, and bullshit from Hustle and Soul. Like, girl, first of all, I didn't watch it when it came on whatever day it came on. I didn't even know the bitch came on until I was on YouTube and it had popped up. So I went on ahead and went on my on demand and I saw the shit. And girl, the shit, it was crafty, girl, because I wanted to fast forward a lot of the shit, but because it just came on demand, it's not going to allow me to fucking fast forward it. So girl, it took me 2 hours to watch this 1 hour fuck shit called Hustle and Soul. Girl, I kept pausing it. I kept flipping back and forth to real TV, then came on. Like, this is what I think was going on here. WeTV is just running out of shit to do. They're running out of shit to do. Nobody really gives a fuck about the Braxton family values no more. All 5 of them are fucked up in their own right. I'm so sick and tired of seeing their asses on God. It's been 10 years of the same fuck shit with them. People getting over it. Marriage boot camp. Like, girl, I don't even watch that shit. I didn't even watch it when it was a celebrity edition. Like, WeTV doesn't give nothing. It doesn't give anything. It doesn't give anything but people that are either trying to get on reality TV or for the ones that just could not make it in real reality TV and they had to go down to the WeTV where they play a whole bunch of segments of Law and Order. Because, and I'm about to say this as nicely as I can. To anybody that really likes Hustle and Soul must be missing some brain cells. That's just as nicely as I could put it. Because, like, first of all, I don't like Anna. I don't like Hola. Damn sure don't like Thandie. The twins annoy the fuck out of me. I swear they're just there for a comedy relief. And then they go on ahead and do their real jobs, which is modeling. I feel as though that's what they need to do. Because they're much more interesting to look at than to watch on TV. And Miss John, we gonna get on that fuck shit too. Like, it's just, like, when the shit first came on, the first thing that interests me was LP, because I thought he was fine as fuck. Granted, he do wear too much of the Beijing down to his fucking face. Beijing and eyeliner, bitch. That's exactly what it looked like, because it's just way too black. And it's, I mean, he was fun to look at. I thought he was cute. This, that, and the dirt. And I said, oh, all right. We got a black brother up here with a reality show. Let's see what he got going on. But even in the first season, like, the shit was like, reality TV has just gotten the more fights, the better. Bitch, for all of that, I could have just kept watching the Bad Girls Club. Like, I don't want to see grown-ass bitches and niggas fighting behind fake shit. Behind fake, made-up, put-together, poorly put-together ass scenes. It's just not real. First and foremost, Anna, you annoy me. You annoy the fuck out of me, my spirit, and my soul, all up and through my asshole and into my ass crack. Girl, your fashions annoy me, your weave annoy me, your height annoys me. I swear to God, both of your eyes are lazy, or either that, you don't get enough sleep because you be sitting up waiting for LP to come home because you know he's still fucking Thandie all up and through her goddamn asshole. Like, I can't stand bitches who try to act like they're so above the classy, but they're just as ratchet as everybody else that they tries to put down. Not to mention this bullshit that you got going on up in this man. Listen, LP trying to be classy base. What part of classy base is you hiring ex-strippers who love to show ass and show titties and twerk on tabletops? Ain't nothing about that classy. That is ratchetness at his finest. Now, if he was opening up a strip bar/restaurant, That would have been the perfect atmosphere for the shit that you trying to do. I don't know why you feel like just because y'all are in Miami, that Miami is just that ratchet and nobody really wants to come there for the food. They want to see ass. Girl, they got the King of Diamonds over there. If they want to go see ass, all they got to do is go there. But bitch, when I'm trying to eat, I don't want to see no ass all in my goddamn food with her twerk win, sweaty ass twerk win or that, all hovering around my goddamn food. Bitch, don't nobody want that shit. Anna, what's tea? How you classy, but you gonna sit there and make turn these girls into basically into to stripping ass servers? But you so classy, babes, and you so here for women, and you are a woman. And another thing that annoys me about Anna, you so worried about bitches fucking your man, but look at the hoes that you hiring. Who got more ass and titties and more of a shape than you ever could? The shit not real, y'all. The shit is just not real. Hola, I was fucking with you last season, but I don't fuck with you no more. Because, first of all, you popped off that whole argument between you and Anika. You popped that shit off. All because the twins gave her, you know, they was more into her than what they was really into you, and she was right. Your ass is jealous. Because let's not forget, you fucked one of the twins last season. That girl was absolutely right. You was jealous, you was mad, and you was hating because they came and saw all that damn melanin magic, and they was so over your Chipotle eating ass. Then you sitting up here bringing in Ebony and the other girl, I can't even think of what her name is, Gray Hair Fish, and Ebony looked just as ratchet and put together as Anika did. I don't see what the difference is between them and Anika, and Anika was absolutely right. Girl, that is not your ass, okay? Your ass do not match your legs from the side. She's right. You have some fat transfer somewhere. I think you used to be a big bitch, and you took all that fat and put it all in your ass. Because, girl, it looked sloppy. You look like a pea from the upside down pea. Talk about something. They're a huge upgrade. Bitch, where? Where? Because all three of them look like they done worked at the King of Diamonds together. So what was the difference in it? What was the difference in it? There was none. I can't stand people who want to sit around and create issues, but then want to fall victims to the very thing that they created. You started that shit with Anika. And is it me, or does Anika remind y'all of Shea Bunky Johnson? Like, I swear, she could be Shay's little sister, because that's exactly what she gives me, all down to her face, to her nose, to her mouth especially. She just gives me all kind of Shea vibes. She give me all kind of Shea vibes. We ain't seen much of Thandi. You know, she running the pink teacup down here to the Brooklyn somewhere, bitch. I don't ask me where that, and no, I have not been. We ain't seen much of her other than I hate her confessional look. I hate Thandi's looks, period. Like, the pussy gotta be good. The pussy gotta be good, because Thandi's face, it must be her ass, because it ain't her face, okay? And she is a tip drill. John John and Cola. Hola, I mean, John John and Hola. That's her name. Her name is Hola. First of all, Miss John John's gay. And I know that because I have a friend who lived here who was a model who personally had secret late night rendezvous with John John. That's another reason why I cannot get into this show. Stop trying to force this forced relationship of Cola and John John. No, they asses ain't together, ain't bit more together, ain't finna be together, okay? Because John John ass is gay, okay? He got a boy puss that he liked it for it to be mangled with, played with, tampered with, and yeah. What it is, they're probably friends, and they made up a contract saying, listen, we both want to be on this show, so you just gonna play my love interest. That's why they have an open relationship, because girl, what real adults is having an open relationship? Like, let us just be honest. For all of that, bitch, you can be single and do you. I could be single and I could just do me. Open relationships are for the birds. I never believed in them shits. That's just a nice way of letting your partner cheat and you try to be okay with it. Like, I... Miss John John. Girl, child, girl, child. Like, this show is just for the shit, y'all. It is. It's fake. It's dull. It's not even really fun to watch. It's really not. I mean, even with the fights, they fighting over fake shit, put together shit. You know what I'm saying? Shit that the producers put together to make them fight. So, I mean, and there's never going to be a resolved issue, because this is really not an issue to begin with. It's all fake. It's fake and it's phony. Like, but LP, I will say this. You did not run a classy-based establishment down to the Brooklyn. So, I don't understand why you feel like all of a sudden you just going to have this up-and-coming real-ass sit down and enjoy yourself atmosphere. Everybody that you're surrounding yourself with, they're all like in it for the reality TV check, not this little check that they get from the Pink Teacup Miami or Brooklyn. At this point, they want the reality TV check. They want the Wii TV check. That's what happens when you put your real business on reality TV. That's why you didn't even need a show. I felt like you still could have gotten the Pink Teacup Miami without the show. If you was good as you said you is, and your restaurant is as good as you say it is, you didn't need this show for that shit. Everybody just completely forgotten that they have a real job. Now their job is reality TV, and that's just what they're given. But you put them in that predicament, so you gotta take it. It is what it is. But y'all, that's really all I got. I ain't got no more. I refuse to come back up here and review Hustle and Soul at all. To be honest with you, I might not even watch the shit at all. I just did it for you, Sheik. I did it for you. You and Greg been bugging me about doing this shit last season. That's why I didn't want to do it. And after seeing it just now from whenever the shit came on this week, that's my thoughts on Hustle and Soul. There it is. Bad girl.